Hello, you've now made it to the last lesson. So hopefully everything is going well in your Prove It project. You now will have the last lesson before you have the next 2 more days to finish your Prove It project. This will finish up with volcanoes. There's going to be a lot of reading, so you'll need to go through the book, and I'm going to go through the vocabulary words. You will not have to do all of those. So we're going to start out on page 134 or lesson 5-1. For lesson 1, you will need to do all of the vocabulary words. So for this one, you'll need to do all of the vocabulary words. And thank you for your patience with the book. I know that there has been some issues with the book being slow, but thank you for dealing with it. For lesson 2, you're going to get a little bit of a break. You only need to do magma chamber, crater, dormant, and extinct. Again, you only need to do magma chamber, crater, dormant, and extinct. And for lesson 3, you'll have Calodard, cinder cone, composite volcano, and shield volcano. So for lesson 3, you will just have 4 vocabulary words. So after finished reading, you should have all of your vocabulary words. Think about your key ideas. You've already started to prove it. Project, so you have a pretty good idea of what you will need in your notes to finish the project. All right, so the things that we have this for today's lesson is you are going to do the Pearson video on volcanoes, which the link will be on the doc. You'll watch the video. It's a short video. And before you watch the video, you'll do why do volcanoes erupt? So you'll predict why you think volcanoes will erupt. You'll watch the movie. We should be pretty used to watching these movies now. And then what were some reasons given in the video for the volcanic eruptions? Did they match what you had? Okay. Then you're going to do where are volcanoes found? Again, out of the textbook. So you'll do some reading, and by now we should have a pretty good understanding of volcanoes. This will be a very important word, and again, also you see with this coming up, this will also read to you. I know that it talked about the text. And then volcanoes often form belts around plate boundaries. How does this piece of art illustrate the statement that is true for North America? Then we'll have composite volcanoes, one of our vocabulary words. It will have a nice short video. You'll then have the questions here, and you'll also have them on the doc that you can fill them in. And again, good practice to go over these to see how we are doing. After the composite, you will get, and again, a little bit of a break for monitoring a volcano. All we're asking is that you take a look at it. You do not have to do any work, but just kind of look at it. Again, use it as a good idea to get you some more practice if you need some more evidence. And it's just a good information, another video. And this time, again, you do not need to answer the questions. And then to finish up with the book, there's some neat activities. This one also, you just have to do it. Maybe just put on your doc or send an email. There's the video, how you did, and it's a click and drag. So I drag it here, put my answers in, and then see how I do. Okay, and you can do it as many times as you'd like. Again, the idea is just trying to understand, especially the words that are vocabulary words. All right, if there's words that aren't vocabulary words, see how I do. Okay, didn't do very well. So that would tell me that I need to go back because I got less than half of them right. Okay, so it's a neat thing. And again, good practice as we're working. Questions that we want to think about. An area where material deep from within the Earth's mantle rises to the crust and then melts to form magma is called an underground molten mixture of rock-forming substances, gases, and waters from the mantle is called volcanic belts form around the boundary, and the ring of fire is a major belt. And which of the following is an opening through the molten gas and leave a volcano? There is also a National Geographic video. If you click on the link and you log in through Google, you should be okay. Sometimes the link doesn't work and you might only get a limited number of visits, so per month or per week. So don't worry too much about that. If it doesn't work, that's fine. So again, as we finish up these lessons, remember, please check your comments. Okay, every assignment, there's a comment. If you have a check mark, the check mark means that your assignment has met the expectation. If you have an X, there is something that you need to fix. Maybe you forgot to do it. Maybe you forgot to highlight the words. Maybe you skipped a couple questions. Whatever the case may be. If you have questions, make sure you email Mr. Eddie and myself. So after today, you'll have two more days to work on your Prove It project. Once you get that submitted, you'll set up an appointment with Mr. Eddie or myself, and we will go through the Prove It project. If you've met all the learning targets, congratulations. You have finished your first cohort, and you are done with the science. If for some reason you need reteaching, we will talk about what is needed in a different video, and you'll have the last 2 days to meet the learning targets. So again, your notebook, great source of evidence. Make sure you're putting the vocabulary words in. Make sure you're putting your drawings in. The assignments, good resource to go back to double check in case you need evidence. Think about your photos. If your photo was kind of not a good photo to see, and I have trouble doing that myself, make sure that if that photo is going to be used for evidence, go back, take a different photo. Some of you have been using your Chromebook. Some of you have been using your camera, and we've been doing a great job. So don't lose out on something you did really well on. Also, go back and check the exit tickets. The exit tickets are evidence. But a hint would be do not do the exit ticket until you do the lesson, okay, because that will help you. Also, if there's discussions that you missed, I would just take this time to go back and see if there was anything that you missed. You still have 4 more days left in our block. So if you have any questions, anything that you need, make sure you let Mr. Eddie or I know. I want to thank you. We both want to thank you for all your hard work. This was a learning process. This was new. So you are learning. I am learning. Mr. Eddie is learning. Hopefully this was worthwhile for you. We know that it's different. If we were in class, I think you know that both of us would be able to do things a little bit different. We would be able to talk to you. We'd be able to do the activities. Hopefully all the links would work, Chrome would work, all these things. But again, hopefully it wasn't too stressful. Finish up strong. And again, check your comments. Send Mr. Eddie or myself any questions you have. And good luck the last week of our class.